Honestly, it's a bit embarrassing to admit, but I can't deny it's partly my fault. I never expected something like this to happen, but looking back, I guess the signs were there all along. My life took an unexpected turn due to my family's peculiar obsession with my appearance, and my own boiling frustrations. Growing up, my aunts and grandmother were always quick to point out how my features seemed too delicate, too pretty for a boy. Their comments, though perhaps intended as compliments, grated on my nerves. I was constantly reminded of my slender frame, my long hair, and my smooth complexion, which they claimed were all wasted on a boy. I tried to brush off their words, but deep down, they stung. It all came to a head a few days ago. I remember it vividly. I walked into the kitchen, seeking nothing more than a soda, but found myself walking into a den of what felt like vultures. My mom, aunts, and grandmother were all there, and as soon as they saw me, the usual cooing and odd compliments began. "You're too pretty to be a boy," they said, as if they hadn't told me 1,000 times before. But it was Aunt Celia's comment that really set me off. She said with a sigh that my big eyes and smooth skin were wasted on a boy and that I should have been born a girl. That comment, so casually tossed out, made something inside me snap. I erupted, hurling every insult I could think of, not caring about the consequences. My mother, understandably, didn't react well to my outburst. And as a result, here I am, wearing a dress as a peculiar form of punishment or perhaps, a lesson. The irony is, standing here in front of the mirror, I can't help but think they might have had a point. Dressed as a girl, I see a different version of myself, and surprisingly, it doesn't look as odd as I thought it would. Maybe, just maybe, there's a part of me that's okay with this unexpected twist in my story. Seeing me in that dress seemed to bring a certain joy to my mother and aunts that I hadn't anticipated. Their faces lit up with delight, and for a moment, the tension that had built up over the years seemed to melt away. They gathered around me, their earlier comments about my appearance transforming into something akin to triumph. My mother, in particular, seemed to embrace this new reality with enthusiasm. She began treating me more like a daughter than a son, a shift that was both confusing and oddly comforting. She and my aunts took it upon themselves to introduce me to the world of feminine fashion. Shopping trips became a regular occurrence, each one adding skirts, blouses, and dresses to my wardrobe. It was a strange sensation, seeing my closet transform, filled with colors and styles I had never considered before. At first, I resisted, internally rebelling against this new identity that was being thrust upon me. But as time passed, I found myself slowly surrendering to my fate. There was something undeniably liberating about embracing this side of me that I had never explored. The soft fabrics, the way the clothes fit and moved with my body, it was all new and strangely exhilarating. I started to pay more attention to the way I presented myself. My long hair, once a point of contention, now became my pride. I learned to style it in different ways, enjoying the way it framed my face. Makeup, too, became a part of my routine, something I had never thought I would dabble in. But with each brushstroke, I discovered a new aspect of my identity. My family's acceptance and encouragement played a significant role in this transformation. Their initial comments, which I had found so irksome, now seemed to be coming from a place of understanding, perhaps even foresight. They saw a part of me that I hadn't seen, and now, it was as if a new world had opened up to me. In this unexpected journey, I found a strange sense of peace. Surrendering to this fate didn't feel like defeat, it felt like an awakening. I was still me, but now there was more depth to my identity, a richness that I had never known. This experience, born out of a family squabble and an impulsive punishment, had unexpectedly guided me to a version of myself I never knew existed but was now eager to explore.